El octágono.
Andrea Calle, estamos aquí en Bellator 80 desde el Jarro Café y tengo el placer de estar con el presidente de Bellator, Bjorn Rabney. Well, tell us a little bit about, I've heard that there's a possibility that next year we're going to have Bellator in Brazil. Is this something that it's a possibility, seeing Bellator in South America and Brazil?
Keep my fingers crossed. I've been working on a Brazil deal now for about 9 months and my fingers are crossed. It would be awesome. It's got to be the right kind of situation. Our show's on Esporte Interativo in Brazil, and it does about 3 million viewers per show. So the fan support's there. We just got to find the right kind of combination to bring three events down to Brazil, and we're working on it like crazy. We're working with some really, really talented people. So I've got my fingers crossed. I'm not ready to say yes for sure, but we're very close.
Would it be only Brazil, or we're also thinking about doing another Central and South American country?
At this point, our ratings are so strong in Brazil, probably just Brazil, but we've got a big deal with Turner, which covers a lot of South America, so we're looking at other markets, but right now it looks like Brazil is where we're really focused.
Okay, tell us a little bit, tomorrow we have the tryouts for the reality show down here also in Fort Lauderdale. Tell us a little bit about what we're going to be expecting, what is it going on?
This is for our Spike reality show that's going to launch in 2013. It's produced by Bertrand Van Munster, the guy who does The Amazing Race. And there's an open tryout tomorrow. We've been casting fighters now for almost 4 months. And there's an open tryout because there's a few spots left. So, you know, we'll see. There may be some diamond in the rough that we find here tomorrow in South Florida. And that guy could end up on national TV on Spike.
Well, this reality show, tell us a little bit. Is it going to be like the general format of reality shows? Are we going to see, you know, is it going to be something different? Can we have any insights about what we're going to be expecting of the reality show?
Yeah, and nobody will get voted back on the island, and there's not going to be a bunch of women in a house, and somebody's going to try to win their heart. You know, it's not going to be anything like that. It will be very much what we're about. It's going to be competition. It's going to be world-class fighters. And ultimately, there's going to be a big prize at the end. I can't really give out all the info on the format. But it's very true to who we are, and the stories behind the fighters are really developed, and it's really kind of almost like watching a documentary competition. So I'm excited about it. You know, we'll have to see how it all plays out, but I'm excited about what it could be.
I want to ask you also, for 2013, are we going to keep on seeing the tournament formats that Bellator always keeps? Is that something that we're going to keep on seeing, or are we going to be adding different stuff?
Yeah, unless they drag me out of my office kicking and screaming, we're going to stick right with the tournament format. I mean, that's what makes us who we are. It's objective, and you win, you move on, you lose, you go home. And that's what we're all about. We're real sports competition. We're not, there's no matchmaker sitting behind a desk deciding who fights who for what and when. It's real sport. It's just like football or soccer or basketball or baseball. So we're going to stick with that. That'll be, that's who we are, and it's who we're going to stay to be, you know?
Well, now with women MMA, you know, it's been all over the news. UFC now just signed, you know, Ronda Rousey, Misha Tate. You've been really strong, you know, supporting the females since the beginning. Yep. Are we going to continue seeing this in Bellator, and are we going to have more women fighting inside of Bellator?
Yeah, absolutely. Our commitment to the women's game is going to stay strong. We've got a big women's fight coming up in Atlantic City at the end of the year, which we'll be televising. Zoila Frosto is going to fight Jessica Eye, and it'll be part of the MTV2 broadcast. Jessica Aguilar was here tonight. She'll be fighting for us in short order. So we're going to stay committed to it and try to put our heads together and figure out when we can do the next women's tournament at 125. And keep moving the women's game forward. There's some incredibly talented women fighters out there. Jessica's one of them. Zoila Frosto's one of them. Jessica Eye is one of them. We got some great women fighting here. We've just got to keep promoting them and keep letting people see them fight. Because when they see them fight, they want to see them fight again.
Well, thank you very much for this interview. Y esta es Andrea Calle. Estamos aquí desde Bellator 80.
El octágono.
For all the latest in MMA, news, fight results, interviews, live event coverage, podcast and video capsules, all this and much more in Spanish. Find all your MMA needs here inside El Octágono, the number one source dedicated 100% to MMA in Spanish. ElOctágono.com.